Students, now in this video lecture, we will learn about object definition language, object query language, and SQL 3. Now, before that, you should know about object database management group. It's a special interest group to develop standards that allow OODBMS customers to write portable applications. So it is having various standards, which include object model, object specification languages, object query language, and language bindings. Object model that we have already studied, that is object data model, which exhibits all the features of object-oriented programming structure. Now, object specification languages, these are two types of languages, that is object definition language for schema definition and object interchange format, OIF, to exchange objects between databases. So for defining the objects, for declaring or defining the schemas, we use ODL, and for exchanging information between objects, OIF is used. Now object query language for fetching the appropriate results, the desired results from the database, we use object query language. It is a declarative language to query and update database objects. It is similar to SQL, that is structured query language, which we use in RDBMS, but in object-oriented programming, object-oriented database management system, we use object query language. So the next one is language bindings. That means what kind of languages are used to implement it. We already know about C++ is object-oriented language, although it is partially, but still it exhibits all the features of object-oriented language. Then Java, Smalltalk, Python, etc. They can be used as language bindings. Object manipulation language, mechanisms to invoke OQL from language, and procedures for operation on databases and transactions. That means for performing any kind of operation, either to select, insert, update, delete, we use these languages to work on the object-oriented database. Now, object-oriented database management have evolved along two different paths. One is persistent object-oriented programming language, that is pure OODBMS, and other is SQL3 systems, that is object relational database management system. Now we'll study the first one. Start with object-oriented language, C++, Java, Smalltalk, which has a rich type system. Add persistence to the objects in programming language, where persistent objects stored in the database. Where ORDBMS is handled by SQL3, it extends relational DBMS with rich type system and user-defined functions. Provide a convenient path for users of relational DBMS to migrate to object-oriented technology. And all major vendors like Infomix and Oracle are supporting the features of SQL. Three, suppose you have already database in RDBMS, it can be mapped to OODBMS by using special features of Oracle and Infomix. Now, object model, we have already studied about it. Object is observable entity in the world being modeled. That means if you want to work upon a real world thing, like if you want to work on university database, or if you want to work on inventory database or anything like that, then that will be considered as a class, and specific instances will be created for that we call them as object. Similar to concept of entity in the ER model. In ER model, we also designate an entity, but in object-oriented model, we call it as an object. An object consists of attributes, properties built in from primitive types, that is int, char, float, etc., the attributes or elements of a class. Relationships, properties whose type is a reference to some other object or a collection of references. The relationships we have already studied, one to one, one to many, many to one, etc. And methods. Methods means procedures, functions that we encapsulate in a class to operate on these attributes. Functions that may be applied to the object elements. Now, how to declare a class in object-oriented data model? Similar objects with same set of properties and describing similar real world concepts are collected into a class. So this is how we declare class in object-oriented model. See, we have mentioned here interface. We can all there is a difference between class and interface. In class, we also define the methods that we use, but in interface, we just declare them, we don't use them. Where we don't use the methods, that is called interface. Where we also define the methods or functions, then we call it as a class. But interface represents the basic or template of a class, then we call it as an interface. Now we have created an interface employee with attributes, string name, integer salary, date of birth, whose data type is date, and employee ID, which is integer. Now this is relationship with another class. I will tell you about this later on. And this is method age, where its return type is whatever will be the age type. That is its return value. We haven't defined it. We had just declared it. That's why it comes under interface. Now we have closed it. Now there is another interface project whose attribute is name, project ID, and there is also a relationship, and it is having another function whose return type is int, and the function or method name is number of employees. Since there are parentheses followed by this name, it represents that this is a method, not an attribute. So see, now what is the relation? Relationship, now we have to make a relationship between employee class and projects class. Now how to make it? We'll write the keyword relationship, then set of projects, where projects is the name of this interface. Projects works for inverse projects, then scope resolution operator and team. Fine. That is, we have to make relationship between the employees who works for this project. And similarly, in projects class, we have to create relationship like relationship set of, here will be one F, not double F, set of employee, team, inverse, employee, works for. See, here works for is written over here works for is written over here. That means employee works for this project in a team, where project is where team is associated with the project and works for is associated with the employee. So see the syntax carefully. Relationship set of employee, team, here we'll mention team that is related to project, inverse employee, scope resolution, works for. So this is the way to create relationship between two interfaces or classes. This is the syntax to create the relationship between two interfaces or classes. Now, what is subclass and inheritance? A class can be declared to be subclass of another class. Subclass can inherit all the properties of the base class or superclass. What kind of properties it can inherit? Its attributes, relationships, and methods from the superclass. So, how to declare it? Interface, married employee, this is new class. It is inheriting features of employee class, and it is having new attribute, string, spouse, name. So it is having only just one new attribute, spouse name, and it is inheriting its features from employees class, and its own name is married employee. So it will inherit all these features from the employee class, and the new feature that is spouse name will be added to married employee class. Substitutability, any method of superclass can be invoked over objects of any of the subclass. That means we by using the methods or functions of subclass, we can access the methods of superclass. That is the functionality, that is the benefit of inheritance or reusability. Now, multiple inheritance. A class may have more than one superclass. You know about this? Two superclasses and one base, one derived class, subclass. A class inherits properties from each of its superclasses. There is a potential of ambiguity where variable with the same name inherited from two superclasses. I think you know about this ambiguity in multiple inheritance. Suppose when we have two base classes and one derived class, then the same attribute, suppose name, will be inherited from both the base classes to the derived class. So there will be ambiguity whether to fetch from base class 1 or from base class 2. So for that, We use scope resolution in C++. Similarly, in Java, the same procedure is used. Then what happened? It will flag an error. We can also rename the variable. Suppose in base class 1, if we have used the variable name, name, then we can use it name 1 in base class 1 and name 2 in base class 2 and choose 1. Or we have to choose 1 means just inherit the features only from one of the base classes, but not from the both the classes. Ultimately, then it will become single inheritance. Now, object identity, which is new in object-oriented database management system. Now, what is this? Each object has an identity which it maintains even if some or all of its attributes change. So, this object identity is automatically assigned whenever we create an object of certain class. Object identity is a stronger notion of identity than in relational DBMS. That means we can say that it is stronger than primary key. Identity in relationship DBMS is value-based. That means primary key is always a value-based. Identity in OODBMS built into data model. No user-specified identifier is required. That means it is automatically given by the data model. We don't need to specify any identification to the object identifier. OID is a similar notion as pointer in programming language. That means the way we create pointers in C language, the OID performs the same functionality as pointer does. That means it is a pointer to the first object. Then OID 1 is pointer to the first object, OID 2 is the pointer to the next object, and so on. Object identifier can be stored as attribute in object to refer to the another object. We can also use it as an attribute to refer to another object. References to other objects via their OIDs can result in containment hierarchy. When we use object as attribute to refer to another object, then this concept is called containment hierarchy. That means this class, this object has contained the value of the other object. That means it has contained the value of another object. That's why it is called containment hierarchy. And it is different from class hierarchy. Class hierarchy means inheritance, and object hierarchy means containment. That means one object is containing the values of another object. Now, OQL example. Now we'll understand how object query language works. See, this is a interface employee that we have already defined in previous slide. It's having attribute string name. Other attributes are not mentioned because we have to work with relationship. Relationship set of projects works for inverse projects team, then semicolon. And interface projects attribute string name, relationship set of employee. Here we'll mention employee because it is having relationship with project. Here we have to write projects and employee team inverse employee works for. And this is its method. This is the same way that we have mentioned earlier also. Just note that here I is small. In interface, I is small. And in set of, only one F is there. See, set of is used to fetch the set. That means the output will be in the form of a set. In object-oriented language, there are different types of data structures like sets, lists, data dictionaries, tuples, and one more, lists, arrays. So in this example, we have fetched the data in the form of set. That's why here we have written set of. If we want to fetch the data in the form of list, then we can write here list and so on. So this syntax have made the relationship between these two classes, employee and project. Then how to select the data? Suppose we want to find number of employees working on each project where Sharad works on. That means we have to count the number of employees of that project where Sharad works. So how to do that? Select number of employees. This is object query language, not structured query language. So how to write it? Select number of employees. This is a method from employee E. That means from this class. Employee class, employee E, E dot works for, that means we have to make the relationship from here, E dot works for, through this relationship, the control will go over here, where name is equal to Sharad. So it will fetch all the employees who will work on the same project where Sharad works. Fine. So this can be fetched by making the relationship between these two classes. And number of employees method is used to do that, where it will count the number of employees. Fine. So this is how it performs in OQL, object query language. Now the similar concept will be is implemented in SQL 3. Let's see how to perform it. Here in SQL 3, it is created like this: create row type, employee type, name char30, and works for reference project type. See, in SQL 3, we create a table or class like this: create, this is row type, employee type, and its attributes are name, and works for reference project type. This is relationship with the project class. Now another: create row type, project type, name char30, here it is project name, here it is employee name, team, set of reference, employee type. Comparatively, in SQL 3, it is simple to write as compared to OQL. Now how to fetch the data? Create table imp of type employee type. This is to create a table from these queries, where imp is the smaller name as that of employee type. Then how to create it? These are rows, and how, we have to create table out of that. Create table imp of type employee type. Create table project of type project type from this row type, and from this row type we have created two tables, imp and project. Now how to run that same query? We'll use select works for, this is reference operator, dereference operator. Select works for name from employee where name is equal to Sharad. So it will fetch all the names where Sharad works from the employee table, because the, it is having relationship between project and employee, then all the employee names will be displayed. Now advantages and disadvantages of OODBMS. Advantages: more semantic information. That means it gives the entire detail of the DBMS. Support for complex objects. Complex problems can also be solved by using this. Extensibility of data types. That means structured data type can also be used in OODBMS into classes, or abstract data types can also be used. Improved performance with efficient caching, faster development and easy maintenance through inheritance and reusability. That means it will reuse the code. Technology driven product for next generation DBMS. Potential to integrate DBMS into single environment. And disadvantages: strong opposition from established players, because those companies who have developed RDBMS in well-designed form, they don't want ODBMS to become popular, to become famous. Lack of theoretical foundation, retrogressive to the old pointer system. Since pointers are used in that, you can see over here that this is pointer access. So if the user or the programmer must have knowledge of pointers also. Lack of standard ad hoc query language, lack of business data design and management tools, steep learning curve, and lack of resources. Basically, it is somewhat difficult to learn and to implement as compared to RDBMS. Now, how it affects or influences the relational model. New features for extended relational model. Extensibility of new user-defined data types, that is, abstract data types can also be used in ODBMS. Complex objects can be used. Inheritance feature can be used. Procedure calls can be applied. And system-generated identifiers, that is, OIDs, are provided in ODBMS. Now, the next generation DBMS. Apart from ODBMS, other kinds of DBMS are object-oriented DBMS, artificial intelligence-based DBMS, expert systems, distributed databases that we have already studied, and the internet. These are the next generation DBMS. Now, this unit is complete. Now, as an example, as an assignment, you have to mention, you have to write clear differences between object-oriented database management system and relational database management system. Apart from that, you have to write a short note on ORDBMS, that is Object Relational Database Management System. That is combination of both object-oriented database system and object relational database system. You have to write a note on ORDBMS and comparison between OODBMS and RDBMS. Thank you.